The past 4 years have been spectacular, and I think one of the biggest reasons I had such a great high school career is because of the people that have been by my side this entire time. So this is who I have to thank. Instead of plopping me in front of a TV or giving me endless toys, my parents took me to museums, other countries, and always emphasized that there's a whole wide world filled with new things to see every day out there. Where my dad gave me my taste in film and my thirst for knowledge, my mom gave me my outgoingness and compassion. They gave me and my little sister the perfect family, and I'm really hoping I'll be as good to my kids as they were one day. Moving on, I was lucky enough to meet my two best friends at an early age. Lucas Weaver and Nicholas Beath have both had an immense effect on my life. With them, I've gone on a myriad of adventures and gotten into heaps of trouble. To call them friends is honestly an understatement, as now I see them as practically brothers. I value every moment I get to spend with them, whether it is playing video games with Luke right after school or barbecuing with Nick. I know for a fact that the three of us are going to have many adventures together in our future. I can't talk about those important to me without acknowledging the Donnie Party, my group of friends. Seeing this group grow both in number and friendship has been amazing these past 4 years. All 15 members have different backgrounds, interests, and beliefs, and I have learned so much from each of them. I am fortunate to have been acquainted with them, and I hope to keep close with this group in the future as they mean so much to me, and I really hope they remember me. I have been supported and treated well by an innumerable amount of amazing people throughout my life, including all my grandparents, my kind and loving aunt, cousin, and uncle, and the many other friends that have helped me on the way. I think without these people in my life, I would be nowhere as happy as I am now. Now that I'm done with the sentimental stuff, I get to talk about the fun things. Honestly, I think almost everybody knows my favorite movies at this point. I choose the entirety of the Indiana Jones series because every movie has had a pretty big effect on my life. I'll always be in love with the eastern setting of the Temple of Doom, the cinematic beauty that is Raiders of the Lost Ark, the receiving of the hat from The Last Crusade, which I still reenact in my mirror, and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, which introduced me to the whole series. While I never really expected to have swashbuckling adventures like Dr. Jones, the movies have always been a kind of endgame for me. Michael Crichton's Jurassic Park and J.R.R. Tolkien's The Hobbit were my favorite books from an early age. I still remember reading Jurassic Park under my covers with a flashlight past my bedtime, and I've never related to any reluctant hero more than The Hobbit's Bilbo Baggins. Both novels let my thirst for adventure flourish in the same way that the Indiana Jones films did, and to this day, I still go back to them when I'm feeling down. Catcher in the Rye is without doubt the most significant novel I have ever studied. The novel exemplifies how life works against us sometimes, and I will always relate to Holden's growth from a discouraged and broken soul into a young adult who believed if people want to grab for the golden ring, you have to let them do it. Because of this, Catcher in the Rye is one of my favorite books that I've ever read. My favorite poem is probably the poem formed by all the chapter headings in Italo Calvino's If on a Winter Night, a Traveler. It reads, "If on a winter's night, a traveler, outside the town of Malbork, leaning from the steep slope, without fear of wind or vertigo, looks down in the gathering shadow, in a network of lines that enlace, and a network of lines that intersect, on the carpet of leaves illuminated by the moon, around an empty grave, what story down there awaits its end?" I love it because its meaning lies in how even in the face of the end of one story, another always begins, showing how interconnected all our lives truly are. I think more than anything from my time in high school, I have learned how regardless of how hard or sad or disappointing things can be sometimes, there will always be a light at the end of the tunnel. My freshman and sophomore years were less than perfect, but these last 2 years have been spectacular. Our lives are cyclical, and I think we all have to remember that times of hardship will always be followed by times of happiness. I think I've also really learned the importance of friendship from my time in high school. There were many times when I had to lean on my friends for help, and every time they were more than willing to do so, showing me how important it is to keep those who will treat you well close to you always. I like to think my parents raised me to be passionate about archaeology. The countless number of museums, historic buildings, and monuments my parents have taken me to see sparked my interest in history and in the ancient world from practically the beginning. I've always wanted to be an archaeologist, and I'm really hoping that one of these days I will be in Egypt digging up one of the numerous Egyptian pharaohs history has yet to find out about. It was really hard to pick my greatest accomplishment, because I honestly don't know what I've accomplished these last 4 years. Up there was trying to make my parents proud, always being there for my friends, and keeping a bonsai tree alive for an entire year. The one thing I hold in the highest regard, even though it's not even really an accomplishment, is being able to be a part of my little sister Maddie's life. She's grown into the smartest, strongest, and hardest working person I've ever known, and me helping her to this point is without a doubt my greatest accomplishment. I honestly don't really know what to expect for the near future. Next year, I will be attending UC Santa Cruz with a major in anthropology and a minor in linguistics. And after that, I hope to attend grad school and get a doctorate in archaeology. In a few years, I will hopefully be living out my dreams of digging up glorified rocks on the banks of the Nile and passing what I have learned about our past on to the next generation. Well, that's my senior memoir. Thanks for watching, guys, and thank you all for making high school great.